Hello, everyone, and welcome to RSM's Tax Policy Now. I'm RSM Public Affairs Leader Dan Ginsburg, and today we're going to discuss the number one question we receive about President Biden's proposed tax increase. Time. When will Congress and the President act? And if they do, when would the new rates actually become effective? Now, as our loyal Tax Policy Now viewers know, we continue to stress that to this point, we've only seen proposals, and there's a long, complex road ahead before anything gets done on the tax side, if it ever gets done. That said, we have seen a flurry of action with the Biden administration since the beginning of the year, starting with targeted stimulus relief in the American Rescue Plan, followed by the American Jobs Act, and most recently, the American Families Plan. So the Biden administration will soon have another opportunity to show its hand with the release of its FY22 budget request and the accompanying Green Book explanation of its revenue proposal. We expect both of these documents to drop within the next week, and then the focus will shift to Congress. So with that as a backdrop, let's now turn to what we expect to see and when. To help us understand the timeline, we're joined today by Jim Alec, RSM's tax policy leader, and Fred Gordon, senior director in RSM's tax policy group. So Fred, let's start with you and let's get right into it. What do you know about effective date and retroactivity?
Sure, thanks, Dan, and thanks for having me. The two documents you alluded to that may be released quite soon will shed some light on the actual effective date question. According to senior Treasury officials, again, we can expect to see the release of the Treasury Green Book, basically a description of the Biden proposals in greater detail, and the full presidential budget for fiscal year 22. And according to this Treasury official, those will likely contain effective dates, proposed effective dates. And this is a similar practice, Dan, to prior administration's Green Book's description, where they put forth effective dates language for the Congress to consider. So yeah, this will be a very, very big development. Lots of folks will be definitely interested in hearing what they have to say.
Got it. So help us run through a couple possible timing scenarios that might come forward.
I'll start with the one I think most folks are concerned about, and that's the potential for retroactivity. And by that, I mean 1-1 of this year. So if you look at the current legislative environment right now, we're focused on an infrastructure bill, ideally bipartisanship, activity by July 4th, et cetera. These are things, Dan, that take, as you know, take long amounts of time to work through the system. And as that happens, it pushes us later into the calendar year. And I raise that because the deeper you are into the year, the less likely it is that you'll see something that takes you back to the beginning of the year in terms of applicability. Now, it has been done before. In 1993, under President Bill Clinton, he actually signed a law into enactment in August of that year. They actually applied back on 1-1. These were tax increases and the state and gift tax increases. It was really, really messy. Lots of folks, Democrat and Republican combined, did not like the retroactive nature of the measure, and it barely passed at the end of the day, but it did. And so it's out there. But again, do I see that type of scenario happening this go round? Again, extremely unlikely. Other possibilities, some other possibilities real quick, Dan. We could actually see something perhaps tied to a official action, such as the introduction of a bill into committee. So that wouldn't be a 1-1 type of event, but something more in between. And we've seen that discussion come up more and more around the capital gains, potential capital gains tax increase.
Got it, thanks. Let me bring Jim in. Jim, good to have you here. Let's take a little step back a bit, and why don't you give us your thoughts on effective date timing, likelihood of retroactivity? What are you seeing?
With regard to effective dates and the possibility of retroactivity, in short, we need to stay vigilant with regard to these issues. From a policy perspective, it's much about political judgment, tax and revenue issues with regard to the FISC, and candidly, an element of political will. What will the president advocate having something like a retroactive effective date is a matter of political will. We saw this, as Fred said, in 1993, but it came at a political cost to President Clinton, where he almost lost his tax package measure in the Senate. And indeed, Vice President Gore had to cast the deciding vote. So the scenarios we have is spread well summarized. It could be 1/1/22. It could be sometime during this year, or it could be retroactive to January 1 of this year. That's an unlikely scenario. But again, we have to stay vigilant with regard to this issue. And we could know fairly shortly, according to Treasury, as to where they stand on effective date and the possibility of retroactivity.
So it sounds like things are heating up a bit. We're already starting to see some activity towards getting some clarity around this.
We are, but we need to see more. Once we have these statements, we need to start seeing from our and hearing from our conversations on the Hill, Dan, that Treasury and the White House are getting more engaged with regard to possible tax increases and the timing of those tax increases. The big goal here is the fiscal year start. Obviously, this is a budget matter at the end of the day. And so the goal is conceivably sometime in September with a focus on 10-1 of this fall and start of the new fiscal year.
Gotcha. So infrastructure obviously in the news a lot this week and for the last several and probably for the upcoming few. If something is passed on infrastructure, talk to us about the implications there for taxes.
There certainly is the discussion of bringing together, at least from the White House, with regard to tax increases and the spend. So we'll have to see if that manifests. The focus, again, will be on getting it done over the summer and into the fall with a 10-1 goal and not carrying the chance of tax increases into next year, 2022, which is an election year, and Congress does not want to be possibly increasing taxes during an election.
Got it. Awesome. Thank you, Jim. Fred, thanks to you as well. So bottom line, still lots to figure out, though sounds like what we're hearing from the White House and Treasury is that there's a good chance we're going to hear within the next week something more definitive on effective date. So getting closer to clarity there. And generally, great insights from both you gentlemen and on what's happening moving forward. So for more, please be sure to log on to rsmus.com/tax policy. For the latest tax policy developments, you can also sign up for our tax alerts and find RSM's Tax Policy Resource Center for deeper explanation of the issue. And to all of our Tax Policy Now viewers, thanks for joining us, and we look forward to speaking with all of you again soon. Bye for now.